So this is an install video for the Y mount for the Precision Matthews PM25 milling machine with the Arizona Video CNC ball screw kit. That's the Y mount right there. Now the mill is stripped down to just the column and the base. We're going to do the X and the Y and then the Z. Now the Precision Matthews doesn't require milling in a pocket on the Y mount, or the, I'm sorry, the X mount. If you look at the X mount, you can just bolt it directly to it, and there's no need for a pocket for your X screw, but now we're doing the Y screw, so it's actually really, really easy to do on this. So we'll get right to it. It only takes 5 minutes. So the Y mount comes mostly assembled, and you need to take the NEMA 23 motor mount off, feed it in from the top, and then assemble it. So that's what we're going to do now. So, let me look. Your Y-mount has the coupler installed, and the coupler holds the angular contact bearings, so you'll need to take them off. So I generally separate the coupler. There's a retainer bolt that you take off. Now, a lot of times I set these threads to be tight. I like them to be tight. This one's not really all that tight, so it spins off easy, but you might have to put it in a vise to unscrew it. I use a piece of plastic just to make it easy. Now, behind the coupler, there's going to be two Belleville washers. They sit with the outsides touching first. And we'll just dump them off, and then I'm going to hold the bearings in with my hands right here and slide the shaft out. Now, one thing about these bearings, if you push a lot of pressure in the negative direction, you can cause them to fall apart, or the little retaining pieces that hold the seals in will come out. So you don't want to use a lot of force taking it apart. So once that's done, you can set that off to the side, and then we're going to install it from the top. And we're just going to set it there while we put the Y slide on. So now I already have the Gibbs strip preset on the Y slide. So when I slide it in, it'll hold its center position, but still be able to move by hand. So we're going to put the Gibbs strip in. Put the Gibbs strip holder bolt in. And so this is tight enough now where you can move it, but it doesn't really have any slop. In fact, the ways on the PM25 are actually super, super nice on this mill. I don't know if they're all going to stay that way, but I mean, it's just completely perfect. It really is kind of nice. So we're going to stick the Y nut holder bolt in. And it is held with a M6 bolt, which we're just going to snug up right now. We're not going to get it all super, super tight, just enough to hold this position. So now generally what you would do, and I'm not going to get too serious on it with this, is you would start taking readings to see if your screw is sitting in here straight. So you pick a reference surface like right here and go to the top of the ball screw and zero, and then you pull it forward and take another reading. So for now, I'm going to pretend that I spent all the time to make sure that it's nice and square, but we're not going to worry about it right this second because this is a video. So we'll install the Y-mount. And the bearings might not be all that tight, so sometimes you got to hold them in, sometimes you're not. This one has a shim underneath them. Most of the time they don't. Black side faces out. There's two sides on the bearing. Blue is the side that the pressure does not go on. Black is the big side on your angular contact, so that's where the pressure faces. So now you have your two Belvilles, and they go with the outside edges touching each other. I do that because it gives you automatic adjustability. You won't have to, once you set the preload on the bearing, they're greased for life, they have seals. They should last really for years. So you have your coupler, which holds everything. I've seen some people really, really over-tighten these. You go up until it has no play and then a little bit more. If you go too much, you'll feel it get real notchy and stiff, and that just means it's too stiff. So it's okay to pull it forward like this. So the play's gone, so that has play still. And you just tighten it up a little bit more. You can just spin it. If it only spins a half a turn, it's too tight. So I'm gonna go just a touch tighter. Ooh, feels nice. So I'm going to rotate it up so I can tighten the retainer screw. This has to be tight. You want to break the screw off, though. And then now, we're not going to put the other half on right quite yet. But we'll go ahead and set the Y mount into place. Two M8 bolts. Snug up the other one just a little bit more. Oops. I want to get a feel of how crooked it is. Now, one way to mess with things is I got a 3/8 shaft that I fit inside the couplers. That just allows me to turn it by hand. So, you should be able to turn them by hand. If you can't turn it by hand, it's too tight. So it also means that something's crooked. Now, some of the mills are going to require fussing with it a whole lot. When the ball screws are tight, this ball screw's been repacked with the tightest balls that can possibly fit in there. So when the ball screws are tight, they'll generate a lot of force if they're crooked. So right now, this actually doesn't feel too bad for just throwing it together for the first time. So for now, we're going to say that's installed. You'd want to run it back and forth all the way by hand to see if you have any binding. You can tell by if you loosen these bolts when it's all the way forward, if it moves to one side or the other, then you're bending the screw. The other way is the ball screw just plain makes more noise and takes more force when it's binding. So if you run it all the way forward, especially on the forward when the nut mount and the bearing mounts are closest, you run it all the way forward and there's a lot of force that it takes to turn it, then it's crooked. And you'll have to loosen this bolt and retighten it or move your center point here. So it may be that you have to put a shim underneath here. It depends on how flat the front of the machine is. Most of the time you don't have troubles. But like I said, with tight ball nuts, it can bind. So that's it. The Y mount is installed.